arts at the Clayton Center. This is the May edition, and it's a special edition for us every year when we do this. We bring the students in from Clayton High School. And I believe this is the eighth year that we have done this. And we're always pleased to have them here. They bring some magnificent work. And with me tonight is the instructor, one of the two instructors at Clayton High. This is Jane Roberts. And Jane, you came through again. This is beautiful stuff.
Thank you, Larry.
You're welcome. Let's start out talking about you. How did you get to Clayton?
Well, that's kind of a funny story, Larry. I have two daughters who are 24 and 25 years old, and about 13 years ago when they were just approaching middle school, I saw I had to get the taxi closer to the house. They were involved in a lot of activities, and I was working at Fuquay Verena Middle School, had a great setup, a very embracing community as I have here, and I just needed to be closer to the house.
I see. So you were working in Fuquay,
mm-hmm.
and then you transferred here. So how long have you been teaching art?
I've been teaching art for close to 30 years.
Wow. She's so young, too. Isn't it amazing? Well, coming here, was it really different? I know Fuquay has a wonderful program over there, but have you achieved what you wanted to achieve here? Are we on par with them?
I can't think of a smoother transition. Fuquay has, I think of them as a very embracing community, and I can't think of a place I would rather work. I love working in Clayton. We've got the Clayton Center here, and I actually, the first year I came here, my students were able to contribute to the remodeling of this through a fundraiser, and we did that for a couple of years. And it's been a very smooth transition. It's been very rewarding, and I've just been very happy here. It's been awesome.
Well, that's great, and I know we're happy to have you here. Approximately how many students do you have in the art program at Clayton? I know not everybody can get into it. It's limited, is that correct?
It's very limited. Ms. Seagroves and I, we probably cover about 350 students a year. We teach three classes each per semester. A lot of students want to get into the art program, but they're not able to. We have so many students at Clayton High School, so the students will sign up for their classes in the spring, and of course the counselors have to start with the seniors to get their classes for graduation for the following year. And as they go through the juniors and the sophomores, by the time they get to the freshmen, there are simply no more slots left for the freshmen. So it's very rare that a freshman will get an art class.
So that's mainly a function of budgeting, is that right? You don't have the money to do this.
I would say so. We could easily use another art teacher.
I understand that's happening all over the country,
mm-hmm.
Where classes are being cut, and unfortunately, one of the things that seems to go first is the arts.
Right.
Not the football. No, that ain't going anywhere. Basketball's not going anywhere. So I guess that's just a sign of the times.
Yeah.
Well, the show that we've put together tonight is pretty spectacular, and behind me is an example of the architectural stuff in this show, architectural things, where someone went out and took a picture of architectural highlights in town, and then the artists were asked to paint it. Is that correct?
That's right.
Tell us about that.
Well, Sue Michener of Zoom In Photography walked with me all over Clayton, and we looked at different things around Clayton that we thought were interesting. Then I was able to come back to the classroom and let the students pick from an array of photographs, and the students picked a photograph and they cropped it and they painted it the way that they thought that they saw it, and I think they did a great job with it. This is just a sampling of some of the photographs that they worked with and the paintings that they came up with. We had several more, but of course we could not put all of them in the show.
Mm-hmm. And then the ones over there, tell us about those. Those were different also.
Artisan Schools, what a great program. We've been so lucky to work with the Artisan and Schools program. This was working with Alan Montague. We did sunflowers and poppies, and he taught us how to work with textured paints, and he came to us in the fall. And Alan did a super job with us. He's very accommodating, and he came to us on a couple of days, and the students had a great time, and they actually used the techniques that they learned from him on several others of their artworks later in the semester. So that was a great experience.
One of the things that I find so interesting about these shows every year is the mixed media. I mean, a little bit of everything here. I mean, tell us what isn't here almost?
Well, the clay mask over here, these are green men. That's also another outcome from the Artisan School. Joe Edwards from Matthews, North Carolina, came and worked with the students this spring, and we did green men. They're made out of pottery. And Joe is a fabulous artist. He can work with any population, from kindergartners to people in rehabilitation. He's a fantastic artist. So we were very blessed to have him with us this year. And these are just a sampling of the Green Men pottery projects that he did with us. I really try to expose the students to as many different mediums as I can. So sometimes I don't feel like I'm really a master of any of them, that I just really try hard to let them find their own niche and just show them as many different mediums as I possibly can.
I was going to ask you about that, as to whether you actually give them an assignment and say, this time I want you to do acrylics, this time I want you to do pen and ink.
Absolutely. Well, we have a plan. When they come in, they have assignments, and if it's in a more advanced class, like an Art 3-4 class, I'll give them assignments. And for example, this was an assignment here. The sunflowers were assignments. But then they also have the opportunity to go out on their own once they've learned how to work with different mediums, and they do have the opportunity to work independently in a lot of my classes as well.
That's wonderful. There were a couple of other shall we say, human interest stories at this show tonight. If you get a chance to come down to the Clayton Center to look at it, you might look up some of these pieces. What else did you want to talk about?
I worked with Sandra Honeycutt at the very beginning of the school year. She is a local artist that came in and showed us some of her painting techniques. So Braxton Beaver and learned a lot of stuff from her. He is an abstract artist. His work is hanging in another part of the foyer tonight. He did an incredible job. Kara Edwards, I have had the pleasure of working with Kara. She is an amazing pencil artist. When you see her work here, you will wonder if you're looking at a photograph, as well as Savannah Way. Her work is amazing. And then just a moment back to Kara. Kara designed our senior mural this year. It's a tradition that the students each year as their seniors get together and design a senior mural. And they make a flag as well, because we just don't have enough space at school to wall space to hang these murals year after year after year. So we make a replica flag. So the flag is hanging here in the lobby, and she did a fantastic job. I think it's one of the most beautiful senior murals I have ever seen. So I hope you will get the opportunity to come out and see what amazing talent we have, and just know that I feel like I'm the most blessed teacher and living in the best community ever.
Well, we're happy to have you, I can tell you that. I think we'd be remiss if I didn't ask you to tell us about the other teacher that you work with, because she's been here a long time.
Crystal Seagroves is the sweetest person I could ever ask to work with. She came to Clayton High School right out of college, and she has been working there for almost 30 years. She actually works as far away from me physically as she could on the other end of campus, but she does a fantastic job. The students just love her to pieces. She is amazing, and she has quite a bit of artwork from her students displayed here as well. She is just precious.
I'm sorry she couldn't be here tonight. Are there any other human interest stories or anything else you'd like to tell us about?
just that I just want everybody to know that the Clayton Center is awesome. We are very blessed to have this facility to exhibit our artwork, and I just want to thank everybody that gets to come here, and I hope you enjoy the show. It's amazing.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for tuning in. Art at the Clayton Center.
Hope you've enjoyed Art at the Clayton Center. This is the May edition. The show that we saw and talked about this evening will be up till the 31st of May. So if you get a chance to come down to the Clayton Center, please do so. I think you'll enjoy it very much. Next month we have two fine artists. Lynn Fry, who is a watercolorist. She works at the community college in the Arboretum. And she's also a member of our association, Clayton Visual Arts. And Joe Tucker, another member of CVA, who is not displayed before but does beautiful work. She works in acrylics. So they will be the featured artists next month, and we'll be interviewing them at that time. The show, the reception with refreshments will be on June 7th. And that will be Thursday night, first Thursday night at the Clayton Center is when we do these shows. And I hope you'll be able to join us. And I hope you enjoyed this presentation. Thank you.